Okay, welcome back guys, with part 4, no, part 5 of the tutorial how to make a SOM server. First of all, we're making a game mode, so I'm going to delete this. Yes, it's not important for now. Then, so the next thing, we're going to talk about the bools, floats, timers and arrays. First of all, arrays. Arrays are like, imagine a prison. So prison have prisoners and cells. So these are like cells. So I'm going to hoppa, and then not here. So imagine this is a prison and here, oh well, yes, a court, whatever. So what is an array exactly? An array is a list of elements and each element can be a value. So we're going to declare an array, so that's always so new, and then we're going to name the array spawned, and then you have these, the brackets. So this is already an array, but now you have to like assign a length to it. So how much cells do the array spawned need? And for this, we want to know when a player has spawned. So we need the player IDs. So the length of the array should be all the player IDs of the server. Well, you have a predefined function that's called maxPlayers. Max players, no, don't forget the semicolon. Max players is 500, as far as I know. It can also be, no, it's probably 500 or 1000. No, it's probably 500. So that's like the same like spawned and then the brackets and then 500. So max players is a number, so 500. So when we have cells, you have one cell, two cells, that's the third one, the fourth, and so on, and here maybe, yeah, well, I'm going to like this, and here's one, this is 30 or whatever, this is 500, like this, you know, like this. So this is a list with elements, a list. This is element 1, element 2, element 3, 4, 5, 6, blah blah blah, till 500. So our max players. So we want to, like, when the player is spawned, we want to assign then an array with the with an element to 1. So we go to on player spawn, then we're going to say spawned, learn to write, learn to type, oh damn it, spawned x is 1. 1 means is true, is it's is spawned. So the x we have to change that, so we had, so as I said, we need player ID, so the the maximum length is all player ID, so max players. So we need to play ID. Well, what a coincidence is here. You can use a parameter. So player ID. Spawned player ID is 1. So actually say player ID is spawned. 1 actually means true. So player ID is spawned. So this. If player ID 0 connects or spawns, it will say spawned 0 is 1. So spawned 0 is 1. So this is a player ID. So player ID 0. So actually, oh yes, forgot to say that an array always starts at 0 and not at 1. So it starts with 0. You have to, it's important for future mistakes or something. So we assigned cell 0 to 1. So cell 0 is, so 0 is the player ID. So cell 0 is now 1. When player ID 2 connects, player ID 1 connects, then is spawned 1. So player ID is 1, spawned 1 is 1. So like this, spawned 1 is 1. So if you go back to the list, so this cell is 1. And you can have like more things. So you can go on, yes, you player ID 2, player ID 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, whatever, till 500. So we now have to know when a player is not spawned. Well, for example, when a player connects. When you connect, you're not spawned yet. So you say spawned, and then again our cell, so our element, so our player ID is, well, now it's not spawned, so now you're going to say like false, so 0. 0 is false, 1 is true. And then when the player is still not spawned, well, when a player disconnects, you leave the server, you're not spawned. So it's like resetting the array element. So spawned player ID. Player ID is, oh damn it, is 0. Of course, you have also more arrays. This is a one-dimensional array, one-dim array. But you can have two-dimensional arrays, and that's like this. So new, we're going to say we're using timers next time, so soon, I mean. So we're going to say player the speed timer, player timer, and then, so two-dimensional arrays means four brackets. Two dim array. More than that, more than two dimensional, you can't have. You can't do like new array and then three times. No, that's not possible. You have only one dimensional arrays and two dimensional arrays. So pre-timer, we need to, well, I'm going to use that for timers, and we have to assign timers to ID. No, wait, I'm saying it wrong. Timers needs. I'm just gonna max players. Then, for example, 5. I'm going to explain that later. So this is two-dimensional, so you know it. So then we have bools. Well, no, first of all, if you want to debug an array, of course you can do that. If you do like, well, actually, I'm going to do that at the end. Yes, you're going to do that at the end. So first of all, bools. No, yes, wait, bools. Bools are variables that are true or false. If you remember, I said 0 is false and 1 is true. Well, we're going to change that. But first, a bool is like declared like this. A new bool, this is the word, and then a double point. And then bool var or something. This is now bool and can only be true or false. So we need this, so the bool, and we're going to do this. So spawned, the array spawned is a bool. Every element is a bool. So element 0 is a bool, 1, 2, 3, 4 is a bool. So if you go back, so 0 is false, we're going to change that, false, false, and there is on player spawn here, true. And then this is changed to this 0 is true. I'm going to say t, the t from 2 and from 2 and yeah, whatever. So this is now a bool. Every element is a bool. And of course, you can debug it. I'm going to, as I said, show that later. Next thing. Well, I mean, next. Next, yes. Yeah, floats. Floats are numbers with a comma, with decimals or, yes, with the comma. Floats are like doubles. Double. And most of programming languages, you have double or float. Well, float is just the same like everywhere else. You declare a float as new, and then just like bool, you have to use the word float, but now with the damn it, with the caps lock F float, and then the float var, and then the float variable. So float var will be a float, so a comma, a number with a comma. So we going to first of all timers. Timers are publics that are called within a defined time. Public on player update is like a timer, but a really fast timer. Where is it? On player update. Here, this is also a timer, but it gets called every, as I said, I don't know, in the previous videos, it calls frequently, fucking fast. If you want to debug on this, it's not possible. But publics are forwarded. So if you want to make a timer by yourself, you have to forward it. But first of all, we're going to set a timer with the function set timer that is somewhere in a sump probably here. Set timer. We're going to use this function to add our timer. So we're going to add a timer with under on game mode in it probably. So yeah, so no wait, no on player connect, I mean. So when a player connects, it will call a timer, and the timer gets every x seconds called. So set timer. Then you have a few parameters, the function name, the interval, and if it has to repeat or not. You're going to call us to call our let's say just Let me think, what should we? Is he going to stats? That will be our function name. Then interval. Interval is not in seconds, but in milliseconds. So every X milliseconds, stats will get called when a player connects. When, so I'm going to say every, what? No, every 3 seconds. So that's 3,000 milliseconds. And we have to repeat it, so true. You can also do 0 or 1. True or false or 0 or 1. But we ha so stats is our timer, so we're going to add our timer. So we ha as I said, you have to forward a public. So forward, then the name of your function, so stats, and then this, just brackets, and then also public stats. Boom. And then the Aculus, or also brackets. A public can, I mean, a for so if actually a forward, no, just a public can be called from in other scripts. Now you're working in desk.pwn, but it also can be called in another script. And that's with the function remote, what's it, how it's called again? Set, no. Wait. Set remote function or something? Going to set remote. Nick, call remote function, yes. Call remote function, and then our name, so we can do like stats is the string, so we have to do the, you know, the this these, and then what was it, we don't have, yes, const format are for parameters, we're not using parameters at the moment. So we have our public. So stats will get called every 3 seconds as we defined when a player connects. And it will repeat. If it's false, so set timer stats 3 and false, then it will only be called one time. When a player connects, after 3 seconds, this callback will be called, and that's it. But when you repeat it, so true, if the parameter is true, then first, the after 3 seconds, the callback gets called, and after 3 seconds again, and so on, until you kill it. So I'm going to debug a bit. So we're going to use our defined. So if de that if defined debug. We're going to say print stats called, and then and if. Of course you don't wanna have like an infinite loop. You have to, if you, as you saw, you have set timer and you have also kill timer. Because when a, like, for example, so when a player connects, it set a timer, so it starts a timer. But when it disconnects, it's still running the timer. And that can cause lag or whatever in your server. So we have to kill the timer when a player disconnects. So we have kill timer, and then it shows the timer ID. Well, set timer returns a timer ID. We don't know what ID this will be. This timer will be. So that's why I added the P timer max players 5. So the two-dimensional array. So if you're going to assign our timer, so P timer, yes, equals set timer stats 3000 true. Well, we used max players like bound, so we have to use also player ID. Where is it? So pay timer, so player ID, and then in the second thing we have 5. Well, this is the first timer, and an array starts at 0, so the first one is 0. It's simple. If you add then a second player timer, actually, then it should be 1. So it's set timer and so on. Oh, damn it. Understand? So yeah. And then when another timer is, then 2 and 3 and 4. And 4, that's it, because you have 5 elements. Only 5, so 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So we have this now, so, and now we can kill it. Kill the timer, so we're going to copy this, past, and there we go. Let's see if a warning float far. Yes, I didn't use that yet, but we're going to use it. So we're going to actually, so stats in the timer, we're going to show our player the stats. So if we have to send the message, send the stats to the player, so of course we have to use send client message. But then we have to format a string also. So last the previous videos, so 128 is enough, and then format string size of, oh damn it, size of string. And now the formatting. We want to send the message, send a player when he's bound, and that's it. Okay. And yes, you're going to show the player's shield also. So bools, yes. How to debug bools? As you saw, we have to also use a format. Well, bools are true or false, or 0 or 1. Bools are used with this. So these are numbers. There isn't any other format that works, I guess, because I tried much things. So we have to use the format spros and d for bools. So if you go back to below, so we're going to say, are you spawned? And then we're going to say pros and d, because then we have our variable. And then after it, we're going to show how much yield do you have. Well, if we Well, no, we just gonna. Oh, wait, we're just gonna. Do how much is. Wait, how is the float called again? Float var? How much is float var? Then we have to assign it, so spawned. Then we forgot something, as I see, and then float var. So this is this, and this is this. Oh no, 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 yes. How to debug a float? A float is %f. %f. Well, let's send client message and then let's color color blue, then our string. We have to have player ID here, but as I imagined, it says undefined symbol. Well, we have to get that player ID from somewhere, and that is from a parameter. If you do this, player ID. Player ID. Yes. And now I'm going to explain actually set timer X, because we have a parameter now. Set timer X is used when you have parameters. So if you go back to set timer X, then you go do this. So function name is the same, interval the same, repeating is the same. Then let's go back. Then you have the format. Well, we have to give our player ID to the callback stats. So we're going to do already this, and the format is these. No, but yes, the format is these, but without the %. So I'm just gonna do D. So D is a decimal or player ID. If we compile that, we have an argument type method 306. Yeah. Ja, wacht een keer, jong! Ah.